caralho. Vamos.
So guys, this is what we are eating on day one. Hey guys, good morning, good evening, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Malika and it's a beautiful morning. Apologies for the background noise, guys. I'm at Mama Salome's house. I am sitting here at the, what do you call this, veranda, or what we call it in Kiluya, Matoche. So I'm sitting here just chilling, and I have some good news today, guys. This is where you sit, just relaxing. You can see the sun on the other side, so we're just relaxing here. There's a shade over here. So guys, I have some good news for everyone over here, and also for Mama Salome. I've already told her. So we are building a kitchen for her. We built this house for Mama Salome and we didn't have a kitchen for her. So we came back to build a kitchen for her, and there's a progress going on in the kitchen and everything. The fundis are on site already. We are not yet fully ready, but we are starting off because it's been a rainy season. It's been raining so hard, and you know, like when it's a rainy season, usually, let me tell you, most people in the village, even us in our home, like, because most people use firewood to cook, we prefer having a separate kitchen outside the main house. So you'll find, like, in compounds, you'll see the main house and you'll also see the kitchen. So she already has a main house, which is this one, and now she didn't have a kitchen because the other kitchen was old enough. It was leaking, it was everything. Let me show you the old kitchen. And also, it's just far now that we got rid of the other house. Now it is used as a cow shed. The cow sleeps there, though it is still very old. Let me just give you a glimpse. This is where the main house was. You can see some very healthy veggies over here. See, have kunde. So this is the old kitchen. This is what used to be Mama Salome's old kitchen. So this is where she was cooking from until, like, she moved from this kitchen because it became unbearable. Now it is a cow shed. The cow sleeps here. You see? It is a cow shed right now. It was, you see the, how the roof was worn out and everything? Yeah. I think it's been here for so long. See? I think it's been here for so long. So, doesn't even, this is the door actually. So the cow now sleeps here. This is now a cow shed. I'm trying to lock it. Oh my god. Okay. I think I have messed. Oops. Okay. So this is the structure, and we want to build something better than this, a little bit bigger than this also. Yeah, because it is just a kitchen. This is how it looked like from behind and everything. And this, since this place was infested by termites, you can see the place is not, like, so good. So in their neighbor, there is someone died there. So they have their, what do you call it? Oh my god. What do you call matanga in English, you people? Maombolezi. Maombolezi. They are mourning. So they are cutting off some trees, I think. And this is her. So this was the kitchen. This is where the main house was. So when you're building, usually you put the kitchen next to the main house so that when you are done with the kitchen, when you're coming with food from the kitchen, you just don't struggle. You don't walk too much. You just walk like a few steps. You're in the main house. Also, when it's raining, you can cook in the kitchen and move with the food easily to the main house. So this is how her compound looks like right now. You can see how beautiful and the house is. Yeah, and the compound is now big now that the old house is not here. So what we are doing right now, guys, we are coming up with a structure here, a kitchen structure, and she's here. It's taking care of lunch. As I mentioned earlier, and I'm going to mention to say that again, like when you're having food is here in the village, like you're the one who is supposed to be in charge for their eating. Like you have to feed your foodies. They will come, they will work, but you'll have to make sure they have what they're eating for lunch and everything. You have to take care of that, you know. So, and this is Salome. Unanawa. This is Salome. She says she wasn't feeling too well. So we've already brought like materials. Have these are frames. They go per feet. They are, they sell them per feet, I think. So I don't even know how exactly this, how many feet these are. But yeah, this is the, where we are coming up with a structure. So this is the before. You have to stay tuned in for the after. This is where the utensils are put, you know. So that house behind there is Hassan's house. The son is not here. He lives, I think, in Nakuru. He has not been home for the longest time. And also the house is also infested. And we are trying to get all these things that are infested by termites. So this is the old house and still where she's cooking from at the moment, you see. So the owner of the house says they will come to take the house down when they are ready. But it's still his house. It's two-roomed. Right now it's an acting kitchen. Yeah. So they are cooking for the foodies and Siku ya kuingiza si nili hata huyu nilimuita kweli. Mbona twa ndio sasa nilifanya. Hata yeye alichelewa. Si hata wewe fundi ulichelewa siku ya kuingiza. Kula kitu hapa.
Mgonjwa. Ndio
baba.
Eh? Utaingiza hii sasa.
Eh? Utaingiza
ile.
Utaingiza jikoni.
Ndani anangoja tena.
Jikoni inaingiza ngo kweli. So that is the kitchen, guys, going on. And the kitchen is not so big. They are only doing a one room for the kitchen. And that will be okay. Just one room for the kitchen with my friend here. Salome na afla. Tunajenga nini mai?
Jikoni.
Good. Si tunajenga jikoni?
Jikoni.
Sasa tukue na nyumba hapa na jikoni pale, si ndio mai? So. Hey. So. Yeah guys, that's it. That is the update. Mama Salome is happy. I've never honestly seen this woman this happy. She's like, oh my God, so God was going to answer my prayers all along. I've been praying and praying and praying and passing to people's houses, see nice houses and everything. And I'm like, when is my turn going to come? So my turn was coming. I'm gonna encourage everyone who is praying to keep on praying. Their time is coming and everything. And I feel so happy, you know, like because in as much as she's blessed, she doesn't forget to thank God and to thank the people who are supporting her. For the kitchen, a friend of mine, a very, very good friend of mine, and also a friend of her, is doing the kitchen for her. And so what we are doing, for the kitchen, we are not going to do like something fancy and put in so much work as the house and painting and everything. It is just a kitchen. We are going to make it good. We are going to make it look good, but we will see as we go if we are going to make it to plaster it or not. But that's not the plan at the moment. As long as we have a kitchen, a new one, and one that is going to accommodate like the cooking side and everything, you know. So that's what's up. That's the plan right now. When we were starting this house, also we started the same way as they are doing with the kitchen. Also, we didn't know we are going to like even finish the house as far as painting. But who is God? Who is God? God did this, and now the house is beautifully painted. Beautiful, beautiful. Like when people even are passing here, because it's near like a road, people will be wondering, oh my God, who is this cute house? Who does this cute house belong to? You know, and I'm very proud to say that this house is the cutest around here. You know, like she's like, oh my God, she was telling me yesterday, nowadays she sleeps even 8 in the morning is when she's waking up. Like she even feels like continuing sleeping. Like there's that energy of sleeping. When it's raining, she's sleeping nicely in her house. She doesn't have like to look for polythene bags to cover her mosquito net and everything, because that was the case with the other house, because it was seriously leaking. Right now, I asked her yesterday, so how do you sleep? And she's like, oh my God, I close my main door. I lock the second door. I lock my bedroom door and I sleep like a baby. You know, I was very, very happy because you can see the excitement for her. And small things matter so much. And this one, like you can see, I don't know guys, but you can just see they are happy, a little bit happier than they were the very first time we came here. Let me see if I'll find that video. I'm going to put it somewhere. But the very first time we came here, things were different, totally different. And for the people who have been following me from back then, you know how things were. You know, for the new people, I think I'm going to look for the video and put it, just a small clip or a short video, and put it here so that you can see how something little can go a long way for other people. And I'm very happy. I'm very excited. I really thank God for bringing such amazing people in my life. Because of you people, I am able to, like, through you, I am able to, like, come through for such families, you know. And we are all happy. We are just chilling here right now. When I come here, I'm surrounded with love, genuine love from the kids and everyone, and I feel so good about it. So the kitchen is still coming up. It's still work in progress. We are still not yet there. We just started, and we are going to get there. Hopefully we are going to get there. So yeah, it's just a kitchen, so maybe it's not going to be as good as the house and everything, but we are going to get a kitchen done for her. Yeah, so you have to stay tuned in, guys. I'll put in more clips of the progress of the kitchen, but that's all I can say, guys. Thank you so much for the love. Thank you so much for the support. And I feel good when I see like some lives being transformed like this, courtesy of you, courtesy of this platform. And may God bless each and every one of you. Yeah, thank you so much. And I think I'm going to see you on the next video.
Mana hakwe? Kau ni nak wes beri saya semua. Mana hakwe pak? Hehehe. Hei, nak mana hakwe? Hei, mulas.
Nak wes apa mana?
Ah, balor ras. Sesa ini nolir, nalu lepas pun, mana pun mahu aku. Kena kamera mana nama kita? Ada cuma resi terkini balor ras.
Ah,
bos, nanti
mau
ni tu ya.
Ada
tu
cina
bawa macam ni, tu apa? Oh, berapa bos?
Why are you coming?
Iangalie ijengwe kama imeangalia huko.
Huko.
Oh, huko nataka ijengwe kama imeangalia side nyingine. Ah, mimi sijui jana tukiongea. Niko nafikiria tu ulisema ijengwe hapa hivi iangalie huko. Ulikuwa unataka iangalie huko. Na hata kwa nyuma ya huyu.
Itakuwa hii itakuwa tu hapa ndio umeona kama alisema kama anaosapata kitu atakuja
pomoni.
Oh, ajenge ingine.
Oh. Na mlango inakuwa wapi hii sikoni? Pale kitoka hivyo unakuja kwa umeingia. Oh, sawa. Serandaro inabaki tu hapo. Sawa.
Ama sangine nitasongeza
kidogo mbele. Sawa, sawa.
Wewe nyumba angeweka hapo nikamwambia wewe mzee mzuko lakini haujui. Mimi nilimwambia hii nyumba. Hii ndio tena. Lakini kulikuwa vile ilikuwa.
Hapo kulikuwa na nyingine
nakataa. Sasa asema alikuja niweka. Niko amekuja asimu nikasema mzee wewe enda soko.
Wewe ndio zangu.
Anataka muweke pale.
Huko nikasema enda soko.
Aje ni anene hapo ndani. Maji meko ya nini ndani? Oh.
Okay.
Uliongezea ngapi? 50.
Ha? 50? Hey, you give me a post in your hand. Hey, you give me a post in your hand.
Inakoma?
Guys, this is an avocado tree. It's very, very tall. This is her hanging line. This is where they hang their uniforms and everything. The backside. Call it backyard.
Eh, na mkono yako imekubali sheveve. Sheveve yako inafanya vizuri.
Sheveve?
Eh.
Sasa hii imekata, lakini ya huko ni sasa.
Hii imekata?
Hii sasa hii ingekota, hii imekota kisa kisa.
Oh.
Lakini, hii naye ilikuwa mzuri, lakini.
Ile pale?
Lakini ya huko na
hindi. Eh, ile ni smart. Ile ni smart kabisa. Hata ndizi umepanda panda naona imejaja.
Nikata nirudishe rudishe na.
Oh. Hapa upandangi mahindi huku ndani ya kofi ya kahawa?
Hapana.
Oh.
Sasa hata tumeona maharagwe.
Kwa sababu ya kivuli. Na hii kahawa yako inatoanga?
Inatoanga na saa ingine hakuna matunda.
Oh.
Saa ingine unaona matunda imeisha yako sijui.
Saa ingine inaweka, saa ingine haiweki?
Saa ingine haiweki. Sasa nikawauliza wenyewe wakasema ati hiyo nataka. Ati sijui niwekelee dawa yani.
Ama imezeeka?
Lakini nimekata, nilikata huko.
Oh, ndio ikaanza kutoka toka?
Oh. Nikakata huko nyuma. Lakini sasa kuweka matunda saa ingine matunda na nikauliza wenyewe kasema ati niende ninunue dawa huko. Niende wa spray.
Waki spray itaanza kuweka vizuri. Umefurahia? Cheza kidogo. Wai.
Nacheza. Nasema kuna kasa Mungu papa
Nia ajabu.
Nia
ajabu. Yaweza kwenda juu, yaweza kwenda chini, yaweza kwenda mbele, yaweza kwenda nyuma, upande upande kwa mataifa yote. Wewe Mungu anakupenda. Wewe Mungu wako mwenye unaombanga anakupenda sana. So guys, this is what we are eating on day one. This is ugali. Okay? And this is kunde. Vegetables. Yeah? Nice. Now this is what I love. Vegetables. And this ugali is meant to be for one person, which is just too much.